Hi guys. So I really didn't intend to film a video. It's like 9 o'clock at night and I'm rocking this new look called Depression. But I was really bored and I decided to make a video that I thought would be pretty fun. You might not be able to tell because I've deleted the majority of the videos off my channel, but I have been here since 2014. There's a few of them still up, which I thought were worthy of being kept up, but so many of them were like cringe, and I just kept thinking, if somebody I knew found them videos, how would I feel about them? Hence why I deleted them, because they were so poor. Although I did make a video in November, which was all of the books on my shelves which I haven't read, and I know that's a bit of a trend going around at the moment as well, so I thought I would review my 2015 TBR of Shame. And yeah, did I actually read the book or do I still have it?
Okay, so we are using the world's most unflattering webcam because I don't know how to turn my camera into, you know, like a streaming thing because I'm not good with technology. I'm honestly surprised that I've got this far. So this is the video that I made in November. It was the 20th of November 2015. And I was basically making a video just showing everybody all of my unread books and what I had planned to read in the next year to get through all my unread books. I have a feeling that this is going to go like I've still got all of these books unread or I got rid of them. We'll see. I feel like this is like the total shame for me because it's not just like my TBR of shame. This could be like my 5-year-old TBR of shame. Where I just haven't been reading. So let's just go and watch it. Okay, so great start. The series is still unread, but I do still own it and hope to read it. That I never read and got rid of. Also, can I have a thumbs up for the music, please, if anybody recognizes this song? I think you're on my team. Yeah, I never read that and got rid of that one too. This is totally shameful. Oh, there's one we read. Read that one, didn't like it. Thought Aerofire was okay. That transition though. Nope, still not read that. That one. Or that one. Or that one. Also, 5 years ago, having grey walls was like, I haven't read that one either. It was really like not known, and my grandma absolutely went ballistic when she saw the colour of my walls, but now it's stylish, so I'm a trendsetter. I think I'm just going to say I've never read a Charles Dickens book. I've read Stoner, and that's the third one I've read of this. Never read The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn. Never read For Whom the Bells Toll. I still own all these apart from Stoner because I read it and got rid of it. Still never read Les Mis. Still have that, haven't read it. Oh, I've read that one, but I didn't like it, so I got rid of it. I've never read that, I got rid of it. I still have that, I haven't read it, but I've read a lot of Sarah Waters since this. Except that one, I haven't read that one. I've read that one. It was okay. I can't remember if I finished that. I think this is where I stopped with the series. The TV show just ruined it for me. No, I've not read The Hobbit. Started reading the movies and didn't like them. I've never read either of them, but I do plan on reading them. I have seen the movies and did like the movies a lot. I still own that and I haven't read it. I also have the second one now too. I read that. I read the first one, didn't like it and got rid of it. Oh, go back. Okay, so I read Clockwork Princess and I thought it was okay, and but I left it so long to start reading the next two that I forgot what happened, but couldn't be bothered to read it all again, so I just got rid of the entire series. Same with the City of Bones series. I started reading watching the TV show and I really didn't like it, so I thought I'm not gonna bother with the books. So all of these have now gone, although I probably would repurchase the Clockwork Princess series and read that. I've read that. It is over 1,000 pages of goodness. Haven't read that one. Read that. That is awesome. That is so good. I haven't read that, but I'm really surprised I haven't read it because I haven't read that one either. But the Batchman books, I spent so long looking for them and really wanted to read it. I've read Jamaica Inn, but I haven't read Rebecca. Didn't really like Jamaica Inn, if I'm honest, which is why I still haven't got around to Rebecca. Although I don't have that cover of Rebecca anymore because I saw a really nice one second hand, so got that one instead. I've read The Bell Jar, thought it was really good. Read the book Faith Made Me Kim K Cry. Read Survivor and I didn't like it. Read Invisible Monsters, it was okay, it was better than Survivor, but still not as good as Fight Club. Read The Miniaturist, it was okay, it was a 3-star. Didn't read that and I got rid of it. I've still got that and I haven't read it, but I love the movie, so I probably will read it. Haven't read that and I got rid of it, and I haven't read that one and I got rid of it as well because I read his debut novel. Well, I started it. If you've seen my last video, you'll know I really didn't like it. Read that. Oh my god, the most upsetting book I've ever read, but so good. Think I got rid of this one. Never read it. Or I still haven't. I've lost it. Read that. It was okay. I still own that, but I haven't read it. I still have that, I've never read it. I still have that, and I've never read it. Read that, I read that in Mexico, that was good. Still have it. Haven't read that, and I got rid of it. Same with that one, never read it, got rid of it. And that one, got rid of it. Read that one now, it was okay. Got rid of it. Read that one, it was okay. I got rid of this one because I thought it was too upsetting to read. Got rid of that, never read it. Still have that, it's my pride and joy. Still have that, haven't read it. Still have that, never finished it, clearly I started it. Still have that, but haven't read it. Still have that, but haven't read it. Still have that, haven't read it. Haven't read that, still got it. Still have. No, I haven't got that anymore. I think I got rid of it, never read it. Whoa! Excuse me? Oh, that's it. Yeah.
So we finished the video, and yeah, pretty interesting, right? So apparently, I like to get rid of books, and I also like to hoard them. I actually thought when I was making that video in 2015 that that would be the peak of my book hoarding. Nope, I was totally wrong. My book hoarding actually got a lot worse. I do really need to have a good clear of books, and I'm very fortunate to live very near one of the largest secondhand bookstores in the UK called Barter Books and Annick, where you can trade in your books for new books. And honestly, the new books that they have coming in are, I have bought some absolutely brand new, newly released fantastic YA fantasy and sci-fi books. From there, I've honestly found some books in there that I can't even get in Waterstones. So I'm very grateful that they take my old books off me and I can get new ones. So when I say I got rid of them books, I do mean that I traded them in for different books that I wanted more than them ones. So purchasing them wasn't a waste for me because I buy the majority of my books secondhand from barter books and they always just end up going back there. I feel like if I tried to recreate that video now, it would honestly be like an hour long. But making this video, I have realised that I genuinely do have a problem. I might make a new all of my unread books video this month and then react to it at the end of the year and see how many books that I actually have been able to cut down. I did actually do a tally. I think I spoke about it in one of my videos when I said, do you want to see how bored I've been? I think I had about 208 unread books. I would be down to 204 now. I'm aware I can't read that many books in a year, but there is some that I desperately do need to get rid of because evidently I've had them for 5 years and never read them, so I'm probably not going to read them now. Yes, actually I am going to do it. I am genuinely going to make that video, but first I'm going to have a massive clear out of the books that I don't want anymore, and then do an unread books video of books that I actually want to read and I actually want to get around to reading, not books that I've had for 5 years on the idea that I might read them in the future. So I hope you really enjoyed the spur of the moment video. I know the quality of everything has just been so poor, but you know, that's anxiety. And I will see you in the next video. Bye guys.